गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू www.dineshmiglani.com। दिस इज ए सेशन ऑन इक्वेशन ऑफ प्लेन एंगल बिटवीन द लाइन एंड द प्लेन, एक्सरसाइज 11.3 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी क्लास 12 मैथमेटिक्स। इन दिस एक्सरसाइज वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द क्वेश्चंस वन बाय वन ऑफ 11.3 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सेशन। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, In each of the following cases, determine the direction cosines of the normal to the plane as well as the distance from origin. We know that if equation of plane is there, ax plus by plus cz equal to d, in that case abc are the direction ratio of the normal to the plane. And if we have to find the direction cosines, then direction cosines are simply a by root of a square plus b square plus c square. Similarly, b upon root of a square plus b square plus c square, c upon root of a square plus b square plus c square. That we know. As well as if you have to find the distance, that is equal to from any point, because here we have to take it from origin. So the distance is simply equal to dy root of a square plus b square plus c square. Okay, now first question is, plane is z equal to 2, the direction ratio of the normals are 0 0 1. Same would be the direction cosines, right? Because when I divide by root of a square plus b square plus c square, that will be 1. Next we have to find out the distance of the plane from the origin. So that would be, let us say plane is z minus 2 equal to 0. So the distance is equal to modulus of minus 2 by root 1. So finally we can say the distance is equal to 2. Part 2 of the question is, my plane is x plus y plus z. So we can say that direction ratio are 1, 1 and 1. And direction cosine would be 1 by root of 3, 1 by root of 3, and 1 by root of 3, right? Then I have to find out the distance from origin. So that would be modulus of minus 1 by root of 3. The answer is equal to 1 by root 3. So this is the distance from origin to the plane, 1 by root 3. Next one is 2x plus 3y minus z equal to 5. Direction ratio of the normal to the plane, 2, 3 and minus 1. Direction cosines, for that 2 divided by under root of 4 plus 9 plus 1, that is 13, 1, 14, 3 by root 14, similarly minus 1 by root 14. So I can say direction cosines are 2 upon root 14, 3 upon root 14 and similarly minus 1 upon root 14. Okay, then I have to find the distance from origin to the plane. So put here 0, 0, this is minus 5 divided by root 14. So finally I can say that 5 by root 14, that becomes my answer. Next we have part 4 of this, 5x plus 8 equal to 0. So direction ratios are said to be 0, 5, 0. First thing, when I find direction cosine, so that would be same as the 0, 5, 0, because under root of a square plus b square plus c square is that is simply equal to 5, right? So I may say that direction cosines are 0 by 5, 5 by 5 and 0 by 5. So that would be 0, 1, 0. Okay, now we have to find the distance. So that is equal to modulus of 8 divided by under root of 25, so you may say 8 by 5, right? So these are said to be the distance from origin to the plane. Next we have question number 2. Find the vector equation of a plane which is at a distance of 7 unit from the origin and which is normal to the vector, right? So what we know, that if we have a normal to the vector and distance from the origin, its equation is r dot unit vector n equal to d, where d is the distance from origin, राइट, एंड दिस इज द यूनिट वेक्टर ऑफ नॉर्मल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल टेक, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल फाइंड यूनिट वेक्टर ऑफ द नॉर्मल. तो जस्ट टेक इट एज 3i प्लस 5j माइनस 6k डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ऑफ 9 प्लस 25 प्लस 36. यू में से तो दिस इज 3i प्लस 5j माइनस 6k बाय अंडर रूट ऑफ 34 एंड 36 रूट 70. तो दिस इज n. नाउ वी हैव टू मेक r डॉट n. तो r इज xi प्लस yj प्लस zk, और जस्ट मेक इट इन द वेक्टर फॉर्म बिकॉज वी हैव टू फाइंड इन द वेक्टर फॉर्म r डॉट n 3i प्लस 5j माइनस 6k बाय रूट 70 इक्वल टू d. नाउ रूट 70 विल गो देयर, तो दैट बिकम्स योर आंसर. नेक्स्ट वी हैव फाइंड द कार्टिजन इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस. तो वी नो दैट r इज टेकन एज एक्स आई प्लस वाई जे प्लस जेड के, राइट, डॉट i प्लस जे माइनस के इक्वल टू 2. तो व्हेन आई कन्वर्ट इन टू द कार्टिजन इक्वेशन दिस इज एक्स प्लस वाई माइनस जेड इक्वल टू 2. तो दैट इज द कार्टिजन इक्वेशन. सिमिलरली हेयर यू मे सिंपली टेक इट एज 2i प्लस 3j, सॉरी यू मे टेक इट एज 2x प्लस 3y माइनस 4z इक्वल टू 1. दिस इज द कार्टिजन इक्वेशन. व्हेन आई ऑब्जर्व हेयर, राइट, तो व्हाट आई कैन से, लेट अस से दिस इज टू बी एक्स वाई एंड जेड. ओके, तो यू मे सिंपली टेक इट एज जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई देम. तो एस माइनस 2t इंटू एक्स प्लस 3 माइनस टी इंटू वाई प्लस 2s माइनस टी इंटू जेड इक्वल टू 15. तो दैट इज द कार्टिजन इक्वेशन. इन द फॉलोइंग केसेस वी हैव टू फाइंड द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ फुट ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम द ओरिजिन, राइट. नाउ when we try to understand this, so we have to first of all understand the method, what the process can be there. A very simple thing, that point is 000, right, and this is the plane, and equation of the plane is given to me 2x plus 3y plus 4z minus 12 equal to 0. Okay, so we have to find the coordinates of foot of perpendicular, that we have to find out. Now I know that direction ratio of the normal to the plane, that is 2, 3 and 4, because these are said to be the direction ratio of the normal to the plane. Since normal will be perpendicular to this, hence direction ratio of this is 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now I can make the equation of the line, because point is 0, 0, 0. So that is x minus 0 divided by 2, y minus 0 divided by 3, और z माइनस 0 डिवाइड बाय 4. लेट अस से दिस इज इक्वल टू लैम्डा. ओके, तो दैट इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन. नाउ वी हैव टू सिंपली फाइंड आउट पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन, बिकॉज दैट विल बी द फुट ऑफ द परपेंडिकुलर. तो जस्ट टेक इट टू बी लैम्डा. तो x इज 2 लैम्डा, y इज 3 लैम्डा एंड z इज 4 लैम्डा. एंड अज्यूम दैट दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन. इट मीन्स दिस विल सेटिस्फाई दिस. Put here 2 into 2 lambda, 3 into 3 lambda, 4 into 4 lambda, minus 12 equal to 0. So 4 lambda plus 9 lambda plus 16 lambda minus 12 equal to 0. 25 or 4, 29 lambda minus 12 equal to 0. Lambda equal to 12 upon 29. That we have. It means point of intersection, or you may call it as foot of perpendicular, is 24 by 29, that is 36 by 29 and 48 by 29, right. So that is said to be the foot of perpendicular of the normal from the origin to the given plane. Now this question is also based on the same thing. Only the point is that here I may say that the direction ratio of the normal to the plane is 2, 3, 4, right? and then we have to simply form the equation and answer it. Right? So all these questions are of the same line, up to question number 4. Next we take the question number 5. Find the vector and Cartesian equation of the plane passing through the point 1, 0 and minus 2, and normal to the plane is I plus j minus k. Right? Now the question is, point is given to us as well as the normal to the plane is given to me. So for that, if you have to form the vector equation, that is r minus a dot n equal to 0. Right? Or if you want to make the Cartesian equation, a into x minus x1, b into y minus y1, and c into z minus z1 equal to 0, where abc are direction ratio of normal to the plane, right, and x1, y1 and z1, x1, y1 and z1, that is the point on the plane, right. Now very simple question, if I make it as r, that is xi plus yj minus zk minus, that a is the point, so I minus 0j plus 2k dot n, n is direction ratio of the normal to the plane, I plus j minus k equal to 0, right, so I just take I as, that will give me x minus 1 plus yj, right, plus k, this is minus z plus 2 dot I plus j minus k equal to 0, to make it as x minus 1 plus y plus z minus 2 equal to 0, right. So with that I am able to make my equation, right. With that case we are able to make our equation. One structure is that one, okay. Similarly, if I apply the second point, if I try to solve it by the other way, so that is x plus y plus z equal to 3, okay. And if I directly make it, so a is given as abc, direction ratio of the normal to the plane 1 1 minus 1, so 1 into x minus 1 plus 1 into y minus 0, or minus 1 into z plus 2 equal to 0. Just solve it, so that gives your answer. Now this is also the same question, point is given and normal is given, so a 1 into x minus 1 minus 2 y in minus 4 plus 1 z minus 6 equal to 0. So that is the Cartesian equation of the vector, sorry, Cartesian equation of the plane. Next statement is, find the equation of the plane passing through 3 points, right. So whenever we have to find equation of the plane passing through 3 points, let us say points are x1, y1, z1, second point is x2, y2 and z2, and third point is x3, y3 and z3. So in that case, the better way is x minus x1, y minus y1, z minus z1. Here x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1, then here x3 minus x1, y2 minus y1, y3 minus y1 and z3 minus z1. Value of the determinant is equal to 0. Now I may simply take it as x minus 1, y minus 1, z plus 1. Then x2 minus x1, 6 minus 1, 5, 4 minus 1, 3, minus 5 plus 1, minus 4. Minus 4 minus 1, that is minus 5, minus 2 minus 1, minus 3, and 3 plus 1, 4, right? Now just expand it, that you may say that x minus 1, this is 12, right? And that is minus 12, minus y minus 1, opening the determinant, that is 20, and this is minus 20, plus z minus 1, right, so here you may write it as minus 15, and that is plus 15, right, equal to 0. Now this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0. It means no unique plane can be drawn because all values are 0. So we can say our answer is said to be no unique plane can be drawn, right? So hence answer to my question is no plane can be drawn, right? Now in this question, same technique you have to apply. I don't need to explain you again and again the same thing. You may directly apply that, and with that you can easily answer your question. Next question is, find the intercepts cut off by the plane. A very simple point, suppose plane equation is x by a, y by b, plus z by c equal to 1. That is intercept form, where a, b, c are said to be the intercepts. A is said to be x-axis intercept, B is said to be y-axis intercept, and C is said to be z-axis intercept, right? Now if I write 2x plus y minus z equal to 5, so what you can say for answering your question, just take this 5 here, so that is 2x by 5 plus y by 5 minus z by 5 equal to 1. So I may say that x divided by 5 by 2, y divided by 5 minus z divided by 5 equal to 1. Make it as plus and put the sign here minus. So my intercepts are 5 by 2, 5 and minus 5. So what I can say, this is my x-axis intercept, y-axis intercept and z-axis intercept. Okay. So that becomes your answer. Next question is, find the equation of a plane with intercept 3 on y-axis and parallel to the ZOX plane, right? Now we know that any plane of ZOX, their y is equal to 0, right? If plane is parallel to this, you may say y is equal to a constant, that is equal to a, okay? Since in the question it is given that y-axis intercept is equal to 3, it means we can say y by a equal to 1, so that is equal to 3. The answer to my question is y equal to 3. So this is the required equation of the plane, y equal to 3. Next is, find the equation of the plane passing through the intersection of these two planes and from this point. A very simple question. Whenever we have to find the equation of a plane passing through intersection of two planes, in that case we simply take it as 3x minus y plus 2z minus 4 plus lambda. X plus y plus z minus 2 equal to 0, right? So this is the equation of a plane which passes through the intersection of these two planes. Now this point also satisfies it because that point lies on the plane. Put it in it, so that is 6 minus 2, right? And then I can say 2z, so that is 6 minus 2, and 1 here, that is 2 minus 4 plus lambda. Also put in xyz, that is 2 plus 2 plus 1 minus 2 equal to 0. That you can say. Now the next point I may say, that is 2 and 2 is cancelled out, 6 minus 4, 2 plus lambda. This 2 is cancelled out, 2 plus 1 is 3 equal to 0. So I can say 3 lambda equal to minus 2, or lambda equal to minus 2 by 3. Now just put the value of lambda here, minus 2 by 3. So you may say that 3x minus y plus 2z minus 3, and in the place of lambda, minus 2 by 3, that gives you x plus y plus z minus 2 equal to 0. Now 3 is LCM, so 9x minus 3y plus 6z minus 9 minus 2x minus 2y minus 2z plus 4 equal to 0, right? So here you may say that final answer is said to be 7x minus 5y plus 4z minus 8 equal to 0. So that is the required equation of the plane which passes through line of intersection of these two planes and from the point 2, 2 and 1. Next statement is, find the vector equation of the plane passing through the intersection of these two planes. Now this is the same question, and from the point 2, 1 and 3, the same approach we have to apply because plane passing through these two points. So just take this lambda, this equal to 0, and then put 2, 1, 3. So it's better in these questions, first convert into Cartesian, then in final answer, again convert into vector. So I hope it can be easily answered, no issue, make it as 2x plus 2y minus 3z minus 7, here put here, plus lambda, this is 2x plus 5y, 3z minus 9 equal to 0. Now you can easily answer your question without any problem, the similar question that we have done in last. Next one is, find the equation of the plane passing through line of intersection of this and perpendicular to this plane, right? First of all, if I take the plane passing through the line of intersection of this, same process, x plus y plus z minus 1 plus lambda, 2x plus 3y plus 4z minus 5 equal to 0. So you may take it as x plus y plus z minus lambda plus 2 lambda x plus 3 lambda y plus 4 lambda z minus 5 lambda equal to 0. X 1 plus 2 lambda, y 1 plus 3 lambda, z 1 plus 4 lambda, right? And here it is minus 1 minus 5 lambda equal to 0, okay? Now, next point is given that this plane is perpendicular to this. We know that if two planes are perpendicular to each other, then product of direction ratio of the normals. Dekho, its direction ratio is 1 minus 1 and 1. And these are the direction ratio of the normal to the plane. So their dot product is 0, so 1 into 1 plus 2 lambda minus 1 into 1 plus 3 lambda and 1 into 1 plus 4 lambda, this is equal to 0, right? That you may say. Now after solving that, I can find that lambda equal to minus 1 by 3. Now whatever the value of lambda you have, just put here, that is minus 1 by 3. And you are able to find your answer that will give you equation of the required plane which is perpendicular to the given plane. Next statement is, find the angle between the planes whose vector equations are given. We know that suppose two planes are there, r dot n, n1 equal to d1, and second one is r dot n2 equal to d2, right? So in that case, if you have to find the angle between the two planes, cos theta equal to n1 dot n2 divided by magnitude of n1 or magnitude of n2, right? Just take it very simple, cos theta equal to n1 dot n2, 2 into 3, 6, 2 into minus 3, minus 6, minus 3 into 5, minus 15 by magnitude of n1, that is 4 plus 4 plus 9, and magnitude of n2, 9 plus 9 plus 25, right? You have to solve it, that is 15 by 4 for 16, 5 20, 4 for 8, 9, 17, so you may say that root 17 here, 9, 9, 18 and 25, 18 and 25 is 43, right? So what I can say that, here it is minus 15, so we can say that theta is equal to cos inverse minus 15 by root 17 into root 43, that becomes your answer. So with that, you can find out the angle between any two planes. नेक्स्ट वन इज इन द फॉलोइंग केसेस डिटरमाइन वेदर द गिवन प्लेन आर पैरेलल और परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर इफ नॉट फाइंड द एंगल. तो वेरी सिंपल थिंग, सपोज टू प्लेन्स आर देयर, ए वन एक्स प्लस बी वन वाई प्लस सी वन जेड इक्वल टू डी एंड सेकेंड प्लेन इज ए टू एक्स प्लस बी टू वाई प्लस सी टू जेड इक्वल टू डी टू, लेट अस से डी वन डी टू. इफ टू प्लेन्स आर पैरेलल तो देयर कंडीशन शुड बी ए वन बाय ए टू इक्वल टू बी वन बाय बी टू इक्वल टू सी वन बाय सी टू, दैट कंडीशन हैव टू बी फुलफिल्ड. एंड इफ टू प्लेन्स आर परपेंडिकुलर तो दैट इज पॉसिबल व्हेन ए वन इंटू ए टू बी वन इंटू बी टू प्लस सी वन इंटू सी टू इक्वल टू जीरो. तो दैट इज द केस व्हेन टू प्लेन्स आर परपेंडिकुलर. राइट, नाउ इट कुड बी इजिली आंसर्ड एंड इफ नॉट देन यू मे फाइंड द एंगल. तो कोस थीटा इज इक्वल टू ए वन ए टू प्लस बी वन बी टू प्लस सी वन सी टू बाय मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस इज ए वन स्क्वायर प्लस बी वन स्क्वायर प्लस सी वन स्क्वायर एंड सिमिलरली हेयर ए टू स्क्वायर प्लस बी टू स्क्वायर प्लस सी टू स्क्वायर. तो विद दैट यू कैन इजिली आंसर यूर क्वेश्चन. तो आई डोंट नीड देर इज नीड टू एनी सॉल्व एनी क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस वे. यू मे डायरेक्टली आंसर इट विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज ऑल आर बेस्ड ऑन द सिमिलर टाइप. नेक्स्ट इज इन द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू फाइंड द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ए पॉइंट टू द प्लेन. नाउ वट द कॉन्सेप्ट इज, सपोज ए पॉइंट इज गिवन टू यू दैट इज एक्स वन वाई वन एंड जेड वन एंड प्लेन इज गिवन ए एक्स प्लस बी वाई प्लस सी जेड इक्वल टू माइनस डी इक्वल टू जीरो. इफ यू हैव टू फाइंड द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द पॉइंट टू द प्लेन इट इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू जस्ट पुट एक्स वन वाई वन जेड वन इन द प्लेन. तो यू मे टेक इट एज ए एक्स वन प्लस बी वाई वन प्लस सी जेड वन माइनस डी डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर. तो दिस स्टैंडर्ड फार्मूला वी हैव टू अप्लाई. नाउ इन दिस क्वेश्चन पॉइंट इज जीरो 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 एंड द प्लेन इज गिवन. तो वी कैन से दैट द डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू पुट हियर जीरो दैट गिव्स यू जीरो माइनस जीरो प्लस जीरो दिस इज ट्वेल्व जेड. तो मेक हियर माइनस थ्री बाय रूट ऑफ 9 प्लस 16 प्लस 144 तो दिस इज इक्वल टू 3 बाय रूट ऑफ 169. तो यू मे से दैट 3 बाय 13. राइट, तो दैट आई कैन से डिस्टेंस ऑफ द पॉइंट टू द प्लेन. तो द सेम क्वेश्चन लेट अस से जस्ट टेक द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. राइट, तो लेट अस टेक दिस लास्ट वन प्रॉब्लम. Point is given as minus 6, 0, 0 and plane is given, right? We have to find the distance. You may simply take that minus 12 plus 0 plus 0 minus 2 divided by under root of 4 plus 9 plus 36, right? So this is minus 14 because modular sign is there 14 divided by 7. So you can say that the distance from this point to the plane is 2. That becomes your answer. So this is end to our exercise 11.3. I hope you enjoyed it. In this exercise we have taken NCERT 11.3. For more videos you may log in to our website www.dineshmiglani.com.